to our channel. I'm Dr. Carol. This is Dr. Meg from Chiropractic Family Wellness Center in Scarborough, housed in Oasis. And today we have some really amazing information to talk to you about for this spring. One of the common experiences that many of us have in the spring are what we refer to as seasonal allergies. There are triggers that happen in the spring as things are budding and shoots are coming up from the ground. There's lots of triggers that create a response in the body that's an allergic response. Typically, what people do in response to that is to take something, right? Because they're feeling snuffly, they're feeling like their sinuses are irritated, their eyes, they may be sneezing, wheezing. The medications will oftentimes decrease the symptoms, not usually take them away, and you have to keep taking them in order for the symptoms to stay away. But the important thing to recognize is that a strong body creates antibodies, and it can manage the same exposure to the same triggers that other people who are having those same triggers, but their bodies are creating the symptoms. So what's the difference? Why is one body creating all of the allergic responses, all of the allergy symptoms, and one body isn't? That's a really important distinction to look at. It's not a lack of whatever, Flonase or whatever medication people are taking that's causing the allergy symptoms. So we have to look at how we can strengthen our bodies from inside out so that we don't need to create that kind of response. Looking at things that are going to create a stronger body that is creating antibodies for you. And always, we know as chiropractors that getting adjusted is a really crucial element. Looking at your diet is so critical. Making sure that you're eating real food and you're avoiding toxins and medications. If you're somebody who takes a lot of medications and antibiotics, then you're actually creating a leaky gut syndrome. Your system is not as prepared and able, and your immune system isn't as strong, so you're not as able to manage the exposure that we get in the spring. One of the things that happens and creates more leaky gut also is stress. There's been many studies to show that when you have a high level of stress, the natural flora that's in your digestive tract, which is one of the biggest parts of your immune system, I never knew that growing up. I was like, it's where I digest food. But it's really the place that digestion, immunity happens. So the idea that stress can break down the natural flora in that system is also really critical to know. So your immune system becomes weakened with stress. And stress can be perceived stress or just stress that you're just holding on to and haven't really even understood you have yet. The ability to adapt to change, we talk about this all the time in these videos, but that's the brain's job. The brain's job is to change you with each situation. So the importance of flexing with each season has to do with whether your system is clear, and getting adjusted clears that system. One of the, I think, the most important diet changes that I can think of right off the bat, and I know we've talked about this before in other videos, is sugar. I'm not going to like this one again, but sugar is a huge deterrent to the immune system's ability to function. Sugar feeds yeast, she feeds, breaks down tissues, and within a half an hour of you eating refined sugar, your immune system is only 50% available. So it's not a helpful piece. So that is one right off the bat that I would say, and starting it soon, you know, starting it before the spring, or starting it before you know you have these symptoms that Dr. Meg was speaking of, because stopping it the day that you start to notice is a little bit late. So starting earlier and getting your sugar tastes or sweet tastes from natural sugars like fruits, if you're not, that would be a better choice. And the other piece I would say, well, you can just put it under the whole heading of whites. Anything in your food palette that has white to it. So the white flours, the wheats, the sugars, those are all really detrimental to the flora and the natural antibodies that you are trying to create in your system. So those are critical to take out of the system for the period of time that you're trying to detox. And spring and fall are wonderful times for your body to create new detoxification. The winter is a different kind of time in our climate where we live, and it's not necessarily what I've understood to be the best time to do detoxification, but completely in the spring and definitely in the fall.
One of the most critical whites to avoid and to eliminate really completely, especially if you're prone to seasonal allergies, is dairy. Dairy creates a response in the body that if you're producing mucus, the mucus is actually thicker and harder for your body to get rid of. So dairy is a really critical white to eliminate. And as Carol said, like if you typically start having symptoms in the middle of April, at the beginning of April, you really want to start being very clean with your food. Eat whole food, eat real food, eliminate the sugar, the dairy, and the wheat. And it will be a very different experience for you as you go through the spring. And it isn't that you have to stay away from those foods forever. It's just during that period of time where you typically experience those symptoms. And make sure that you're, at the same time that you're doing an elimination of foods, that you're building your body up, that you're getting outside and you're moving, that you're getting your chiropractic adjustments. And if you do have symptoms, there are things like neti pots that are really helpful for really cleaning out your sinuses. Check in with acupuncture. That can be a really helpful tool to manage any kind of allergy symptoms you might be experiencing. Looking at what tools you can incorporate as well as looking at things you want to eliminate, it's really a balance of those two ideas. Thanks for joining us. We'll see you next time.